Don't you ever draw with an oval. Don't you ever draw anything with an oval. Never. If you're an animation professional, illustration professional, yeah, use ovals, all right? But we're going to be getting into why students shouldn't use ovals, all right? And I'm just going to be talking about that, and we're going to be getting to your drawing challenge at the end of the video, all right? So come on, let's go. Come on. The reason you don't want to use an oval as a student is because it represents indecision. Right here, you see there's an X and there's a check mark. This is mistakes. This is good things, you know, the good path, the path of the light, the path of the dark. As you know, if you've watched my videos, I talk about this shape all the time. And another one of my videos is called the lemon slice. Okay, yeah, we're just gonna call it a triangle with the dominant side. Triangles are so important because they are the most simple shape that you can make that is balanced. Why is this so important? Because it has a taper. All right, it's got a small section. And it's got a large section. Go check out my other video if you want to learn more about the lemon slice and why it's just so freaking important. And I'm just going to give you some examples of why it's so important, show you some professionals' work, and we're just going to kind of break it down, all right? In the indecision ovals, let's say you're trying to break down a professional's work, especially in the learning phase, you are sticking to an indecisive way. Which side is favored? Where does the body turn? Which way does the hip turn? Yada, yada, yada. If you use an oval, it forces you into using a shape that has no decision. And why is decision so important? Because there are only two paths you can do, that is right or wrong. And I know, it's so scary. It's so scary to do the wrong things. Well, you just need to shut up. You should shut your little baby. You're whining. You're always whining. And you just need to realize that it's okay to make mistakes. Not only is it okay to make mistakes, but it's even more important to make mistakes than it is to do the right thing. And I also made another video about that. You go check out that video, come back to this one. So you start here, and let's say you make the mistake. If you're going back and referencing a professional artist, like I say to do all the time, you realize that you've made the mistake. This can lead you to making the right choice. This brings you down to getting learnt. That's the difference. That's the difference between indecision and decision. Nothing learnt, indecision, learnt. That's why we use reference, because as soon as you realize you've done something wrong, boom, you're stuck on the right path. There you go. So let's say you make a mistake, you did it wrong, and then maybe you try again. However you spell that. Boom, you try again, let's say you fail again. Whoa, you fail again here. Oh, you fail again here. Eventually, if you're smart, if you observe and use reference, and you just keep it going. Don't stay on one thing. Don't do this. Don't make a mistake, and then boom, come back around to the mistake. And then boom, come back around to the mistake. This is really important for drawing, obviously, but I wanted you to realize this is big picture, baby. This applies to life. So hardcore. I've known people that get stuck in this indecision rut. They're always doing ovals in their life. They're like, I'm too scared to make the wrong decision, so I don't make the right decision. And then you're just stuck in this in-between, in this limbo. You're safe and neutral. You feel cozy. You feel like life is just holding you and just, you're not doing anything wrong or anything right. But you know what? It's comfortable, but you don't learn anything. Nothing's learned. It's tough. It's really tough, but to develop, to get better faster, you gotta make mistakes. They're not bad mistakes, baby. They're all right. All right, you just keep on making them and you keep on moving. That's enough of that. Just like we move on from mistakes, we're gonna move on to the next subject. All right, one of the most important sections of the video is a reference, all right? You gotta get your reference, your professional reference. So let's go. All right, first reference, somebody that I've always looked up to and stolen her work, Grace. Grace is awesome. I'm sure you've seen her work around. So look at this. This is an overall shape right here. Grace may not be savvy to the fact that she's using this, but she's still using it. That means that it's just innately a good designing tool. She's doing it here too. And you think, well, it's not technically a favored sided triangle because look at this shape. That's not the same shape. Yeah, because you freaking look. It's the same shape. Essentially, it's the same shape. So quit. Shut up. Look, her leg's doing the same thing. It's super important to use this and to realize it when you're breaking down professional artists. Because again, it's forcing you to make a decision on where things turn, especially in figure drawing. If you're breaking down photographs like that, it's forcing you to decide where the figure turns. Go check out Grace's work. She's top of the line. She's super pro, pro pro. All right, I actually know Grace in person. She's a really cool person. Maybe someday I can get her on the show. Not that I'm actually gonna be making any more videos because this is actually my last video. Sorry, I forgot to tell you guys. This is my last video. Moving on. You know, I talk about this guy a lot too. Sean Galloway. Let's go into Sean's work, huh? I always love this guy. I always love breaking down his work. So right here, you can kind of be confused. You'd be like, whoa, look at this. Look at this bump. Wow, look at that bump. Look at this bump. Look at all these bumps. There's so many things. No. That's wrong, right? Forget about that. Look at the big picture. What's the big picture? Is this favor-sided triangle with a butt cheek. You see that butt cheek right there? He's splitting it down the middle. Here's the video that I was talking about, by the way. Fixing Marco's art with lemons. So that's pretty much what I was doing in that video. But here I'm kind of going into depth about it a little bit more. And also there I talk about balance and counterbalance of these body parts. See how this one does this, and the booty's gonna go out this way, and then the thigh's gonna come out this way. It's all about counterbalancing. If you break down his work, you can really see it here throughout all of these, throughout all of them. Go check out Sean Galloway's work, break it down. He's like a master of simplification. It's super important. All right, I'm gonna go into the submissions for the reference challenge I recently did. What it is, if you haven't heard of it, I tell you to take a picture of yourself and then draw from the photo reference that you do. I didn't think a lot of people would be doing it. They hear advice, but they don't really do it. But you guys are actually doing it and you're acing it. The interesting thing is, like, I'll click on an Instagram profile that submitted to the challenge, and a big majority of your work, it's not that good. It's not that solid. But as soon as I see that you put up a post about the reference challenge, that you're taking a picture, a reference picture of yourself, and then you're drawing next to it, you're noticing structure and you're replicating the structure immediately. I'm seeing progress. The progress is incredible. You guys should really keep doing that. If you look on these profiles, you can see where they're like loosey-goosey and not doing, the structure's not there. But as soon as they start doing the reference challenge, boom, they're freaking nailing it. We're not looking for perfection, we're looking for progress here. And this guy's doing it perfect. For one, I wanna point out he's doing multiple. That's freaking awesome. That's exactly what I want you to be doing. If you wanna progress, you do multiple. Okay, so he's taking these angles, he's going in here and referencing these angles. Exactly what I'm looking for. This guy's acing it, all right? Keep that going. This is what I'm kind of talking about the ovals. And whenever I first started breaking down photographs, started breaking down professional artists, I used ovals a lot. And I saw that it led to indecision. I think she did really well for this, but I think she could really do a lot better if she used favored triangle thing. All right, there's nothing really to break down with this one because it's mainly a stylistic choice. But this person is doing posing. The pose is dynamic. It feels like this triangle motion going on. The way the person's holding these swords is really cool. It's a really cool pose. Do more stuff like that. That's awesome. So if you remember from last time, the reference challenge was you have to mix and match two words, like a what and a whom. And this guy chose cocky gangster. Everybody knows how to design a gangster, but how do you actually add character to them? How do you give them an attitude or whatever? So this determines their pose, this determines their facial expressions. That's why it's so important to combine these two words. I feel like this person was doing it awesome, really cool design. All right, this was really cool too. This was a seductive hunter that she designed. So faces are extremely tough, and I think she did a really good job here. She kind of went in and broke down these angles from her original drawing. So really cool stuff. Really wanted to highlight that one. This one's combo is Lazy Hunter. This guy did perfect. The lazy hand here, getting scrunched back in this hilarious position, pushed back on his own face. I could just imagine a character like that in a show. I could already, just from this one image, I can already imagine a character and how this character would be written. That really cracked me up. That was pretty funny. All right, this guy, I have nothing to say about this one. I really like this painting. This pose is really good. The painting's awesome. Just all around good job, so. Pretty Gucci. Okay, let's break this one down really fast. Typically, I break down things where I see potential, and this person's got a lot of potential with their art. You just need to learn a little bit more structure. So, just like I was talking about before, anything can be broken down with the favored sided thing. This side has a straight, and this side has a curve. That's what we're focusing on. Let's copy this and bring this over here. This person's chest isn't moving in the same way, in the same dynamic pose. Also, right here, just like I talked about in the other video, there's gonna be a counterbalance. So the neck is coming out this way, and the head's gonna be coming back here to counterbalance the neck. And now you're gonna be looking at relative location. So if you break down the photograph, you say, how far realistically is it away? Look, it's right next to her nose.
So that arm should be pushed back. So that's how we kind of go about breaking down photographs. Let's compare this line. The fist is right next to the nose still. So you did that pretty well. All right, that was pretty good. All right, but let's look at how big the fist is. Whenever you're using a wider lens, it's gonna be closer to the camera. Let's just see how big the hand is. The hand's freaking huge compared to the head. Let's see how big this hand is. This hand is almost the same, or it's smaller than the head almost. That's how foreshortening works. All right, but that's another video, all right? We're moving on. So really good job with that one. Just some things to point out right there. Okay, I'm always seeing this artist progress like super fast. This artist is doing breakdowns like nobody else. Fish Gort. I'm just gonna call you Fish. Fish, you're freaking killing it. One thing I wanna say is, whenever I first saw this, I thought, this is awesome. But whenever I look at this image, I think the pose feels weird. It feels like it's not balanced. But right here, it feels balanced. Right here, it feels balanced. So why is it not feeling balanced right here? I'll tell you why, because you put a background in it. And when you put the background in something like this, you gotta make sure the horizon line, the perspective is correct. Otherwise, it'll feel kind of strange. And so you say, well, how do you do that? Well, what you did here, the reference, boom, you freaking nailed it. You nailed the reference right here. But what you wanna do is in at least one of these reference shots, and I hope you're doing the reference in the same location, pretending like you're right above this person in the exact same spot. Find like a cabinet. I can see you're in your bathroom here. So maybe you have a cabinet that's doing this. Maybe you have a cabinet or a sink right here, right? Maybe you got your bathtub right here. Let's just say you've got another cabinet or something right here. So what you're going to do is you're going to find the perspective grid that these things are sitting on. And you can see that maybe this one comes down to here. What I'm trying to do right now is explain foreshortening, explain how perspective works in a few seconds. All right, and that's not going to be the best explanation. But I'm just trying to give you a pointer because I think you're almost there. But let's say this cabinet goes that way. This cabinet's going this way. You can kind of follow their perspective grids. Maybe even the image is so wide that you can see some of the ceiling, something on the ceiling that's showing which way the perspective's going. Maybe you've got tiled floors. And then it all comes to this horizon line. This is the horizon line. Anything above it, you'll be looking up at it. Anything below it, you'll be looking down at it. Overall, my point is study the environment in your photo reference, especially when you're learning, and then you can kind of connect that to this, and you can see the horizon line should probably be right around here to make the character sit in the environment. So right here, your horizon line is right here. It's literal, a literal horizon that you have going on. Yeah, and so the dock would also follow the perspective grid. Okay, that's just a little bit of a perspective talk. By the way, Fish did aggressive, seductive pirate. Nailed it. For one, the pose is like seductive, so you're kind of sitting on top of somebody, and aggressive, you got the sword pinning them down, and you got the expression right. It's just a really cool, inventive pose. If you don't have to add the word right next to these characters, and people can look at the image and say, that's an aggressive, seductive pose, then you've nailed it. All right, moving on. This guy, I've seen him post, and it's just so cool because his characters, they got so much character. It's really awesome. This one's called The Depressed Gangster. So like I said with the other one, if you can look at this image and you don't have to add the words to it, you can tell what the character is, then you've nailed it. And this guy did so well. For one, the perspective is awesome. It's in like an upshot. So you can see his face kind of peeking through. Got his freaking Desert Eagle here. And he's just sad. You can see he's just sad. I think he did perfect on this one. Nailed it. Awesome job, Crunchy. Okay, the perspective in this one, the foreshortening, the character overlap, the environment, everything about this is really, really cool. I don't see a description of what this person is, but it's some type of psycho. So you want to give your characters props sometimes. Already with this prop, drinking, just casually drinking a soda pop, and like kind of looking down at the kill, casually drinking, immediately, it's a psycho. You know it's a psycho. So really good job with that. So your environment here, if you keep some of this stuff in, you can delete it later, but you see this has a perspective grid to it. And if she had some on her ceiling, you could see that it comes out like this. Okay, there's a lot of information here that we can take away from this image. So if you're doing an environment and you're trying to place your characters in a 3D space, that's really important. Even if you're not, it's important to understand this stuff because you'll understand which way the head is curving, how the character is going to sit in this space will determine their pose. Awesome job with this one. Dope. All right, lastly, I want to point out this dude. I think this guy is the winner. He's got to be the winner because, for one, the expression's so good. The angle is awesome. Lazy delivery guy. Nailed it. Camera's looking down from like somebody's doorway. You got like a camera up, but the guy did perfect here. He's got the expression down. He's got the like lazy. Everything's really cool about it. Also, what is so darn cool is he's got his reference up here, baby. This is from Siyun Kim or Jin Kim. One of those two. I think it might be Jin Kim's work. Go check out my other videos to learn more about those two artists. But this guy's doing it right. All right, he's got his reference up. It really comes through in the design, in the drawing that you did. It looked like professional work. And it's because you're breaking down a professional's work on the side. All right, so that's what I want to see. All right, so I'm going to break this one down really fast. I can already see here you couldn't decide what exact shape this was. So you just kind of did this thing. Which is okay. It's not good for learning necessarily, but I can understand why you did it. I've done that plenty of times. All right, so we're gonna make our sighted favored thing right here, just for learning purposes. Let's just try to figure it out. Oh, there it is. Look, you're getting closer. All right, that's about it right there. Why is it ending here? Because that's the end of this shape. That's the start of a whole new shape, which is the hip area. And I know the stomach or the chest or whatever doesn't go down in this direction. It's just teaching us that there's a favored side. Okay, these things can be hard to break down sometimes too, because you're thinking, is it a jacket? Am I breaking down the jacket? Are you breaking down the arm inside? All right, sometimes you have to take clear reference. And I can tell that it's hard to study these things because, you know, where's the arm? I don't really know. So sometimes you need to take more clear reference or do figure drawing, you know, study naked people. There, I got some little bit of drawings here that I'm gonna be posting later, but you can kind of see I'm using this some of the same stuff here. Just a lot of triangles, a lot of the same stuff. All right, so that's pretty much it. Boom! Don't you ever draw with an oval again. That's why you should have a decision versus indecision. If you haven't heard of Skillshare, you go check that out. And if you like this content, if you like the videos that I'm trying to produce, then I want you to take a second, ring that bell.